What's going on, guys? So you probably clicked on this video because you're thinking about getting a ferret and you're leaning towards putting them on a raw diet. Or maybe you already have a ferret on a kibble diet and you're considering making the switch to raw. Although I won't exactly be discussing the transitioning process in this video, I will be discussing their nutritional requirements, how much and how frequently you should be feeding them, how I personally go about prepping their meals, and just some additional tips to keep your ferrets in optimal health on a raw meal plan.
Now, because ferrets are obligate carnivores and require nutrients found in animal flesh, it only seems appropriate to implement a raw diet because this is naturally what they would eat in the wild. Of course, we are referring to the domesticated ferret, however, their closest wild relatives, the polecat, share the same dietary needs. Their natural diet would consist of animals such as mice and other rodents, rabbit, birds, amphibians, and other small mammals, but there are other healthy raw options you could include in their diet, such as beef, chicken, duck, turkey, lamb, fish, egg yolk, and many more. It's important to know that ferrets, being obligate carnivores, lack the necessary physiology required to fully digest plant matter or other types of foods, which is another reason to be feeding them what is biologically appropriate. Your ferrets should be given a variety of muscle meats, organs, and edible bone throughout the week in order to maintain a balanced diet and fulfill their nutritional needs. Not giving your ferret a balanced raw diet could be even worse than providing them with a low-grade commercial kibble, as they are not receiving the proper nutritional profile. But what's wrong with kibble? As I mentioned earlier regarding the ferret's physiology, kibble is made with ingredients that ferrets are unable to digest, which can lead to health complications and diseases such as insulinoma. They possess fillers, artificial vitamins, low-quality meats, and animal byproducts, which will leave wide nutritional gaps that can only be fulfilled feeding them a balanced, natural diet. So, what is considered a balanced diet? A balanced diet consists of a variety of different proteins from different animal sources. For example, beef, chicken, and pork would classify as three different types of proteins versus just feeding chicken every day because they'll just be receiving the same nutritional profile without any variety. Ferrets also need access to omega fats, vitamins, and taurine, which is an essential part of their diet and can be found in highly active muscles such as hearts or tongue. Not giving your ferrets an adequate amount of taurine can result in a number of health complications, so it is imperative that they are receiving an adequate amount of this. To be sure that my ferrets are receiving balance, I have them on a Frankenprey diet, which is just a variety of meats from different animals spread out throughout the week, and I will supplement them with whole prey every other day or so to be sure that nutritional gaps are being filled, which is what my veterinarian also recommends, who is very familiar with the raw diet and ferrets overall. And that's another thing to be aware of. Make sure you are going to a vet that has plenty of experience working with ferrets and take a more holistic approach, because there are veterinarians that do not have as much knowledge in this area, and a lot of them will recommend commercial kibble. So after watching this video, I highly encourage you to do a lot more research regarding this regimen, as you should always review multiple sources of information before making any decisions. Make sure if you are feeding whole prey, you are feeding a fully matured animal, such as an adult mouse versus a pinky, because the pinky is not fully developed, therefore lacks the nutritional values your ferret needs. Pinkies, chicks, and other juvenile animals are perfectly fine to feed and do have some nutritional value, but it's not enough to meet your ferret's requirements. There is other options of raw feeding, such as freeze-dried raw in commercial grinds, but for the sake of keeping this video a reasonable length, I'm going to focus more on discussing the Frankenprey diet, because that's what I do and it is the most cost-effective way of feeding, even though it may not be as convenient as far as time and preparation compared to the others. If you'd like to see videos in the future regarding the other raw options, let me know in the comments and I will make one in the future, but in the meantime, I highly recommend watching some other YouTube videos that are very informative and cover more of those details. There are also forums online and groups on social media, such as Holistic Ferret Forum, where you can obtain more of this information and ask experienced ferret owners any questions you have pertaining this. Earlier I mentioned that variety is key, however when you just begin implementing a raw diet for your ferret, I highly recommend feeding just one animal food source because your ferret could potentially have a food allergy to a particular animal product. So I would start off feeding just chicken products such as chicken wing, neck, gizzard, heart, and liver. That way it is easier to eliminate variables if your ferret shows any signs or symptoms of a food allergy. It is much easier to determine with this method versus just giving them a whole bunch of different animal products right in the beginning. After this, you can just repeat the process, introducing new types of proteins. So now that we've covered general information about your ferret's nutritional requirements, let's talk about how much and how frequently you should be feeding your ferret. If you have a kit, you should be feeding them as much as they'll eat, as they do have an increased appetite and are in the process of developing into a healthy, strong adult. Kits eat about 40% of their body weight per day, and they require double the bone and meat meals as adult ferrets. My kit will eat 4 or more times a day versus my adult ferrets, who will eat about 2 to 3 times a day. Ferrets are great self-regulators and will not overeat, such as a dog or a pig, which is great because you can leave them access to food all day without this concern. Plus, being on a raw diet, your ferret is extremely unlikely to have weight issues versus being on a kibble diet. Ferrets should be eating 75 to 80% muscle meat, with 15% of heart being included in this because of their taurine requirement, and heart is considered a muscle meat, not an organ. 10 to 15% should be raw meaty bone, 5% should be liver, and an additional 5% of another secreting organ. Now, how much and what in particular you are feeding your ferrets will vary based on your ferret. Females will usually eat 1 to 3 ounces a day versus males, who will consume anywhere from 2 to 4 ounces a day. The season may also determine how much they will eat, as they tend to eat more in the winter and less in the summertime. There are foods that your ferret may stay away from and not like that much compared to other ferrets, and depending on their age, sex, and weight, may determine how much they'll want to eat. My adult ferrets don't seem to like chicken feet or beef liver that much, as they'll barely touch their food versus other ferrets I've seen that really love these types of raw options. Every now and again I'll try to reintroduce these things, but it is clear to me now that they just don't like it very much. If your ferret does not finish their food, or you give them a food they may not like, it is very possible that they will stash their leftovers, and this can be more of a concern if you have free-range ferrets such as I do.
Ow.
So let's get on to meal prepping. Here's a display of the average weekly meal plan raw-fed ferret owners refer to. This incorporates the types of muscle meats, edible bones, and organ that your ferrets should be receiving throughout the course of the week. Once you've done this enough times, it becomes a subconscious habit and you will most likely no longer need to refer to this chart. I've been doing this for years now, so their meal preparation requirements come as second nature to me, so do not be overwhelmed with this information, as you will become a lot more familiar with this once you've done the process quite a few times. As far as prepping their meals, be sure that the process is sanitary and you are washing your kitchenware, countertops, and hands to decrease the risk of any bacteria exposure, such as salmonella. If you are just implementing this diet and are prepping a variety of animal products, be sure to wash your dishes and hands in between to avoid any risks of food allergies like I mentioned earlier. But if you are just starting out, I suggest you prep one type of animal product and continue from there. Some people like to prep their ferrets' meals weekly, however, I will purchase everything in bulk and prep for about 3 to 4 weeks ahead. What I'll do is cut up anything that needs to be given in smaller portions, and I will individually bag those portions by weight and then store them in the freezer, and I will thaw them out within a reasonable time frame prior to giving them a meal. This is more efficient because I don't have to meal prep every week and go to the store as often. Some of the meats I purchase are already frozen, but the majority of what I get is fresh from a butcher or meat market. It may be difficult to find certain types of products like frog legs, rabbit, quail, or certain types of organ, for example, so I recommend that you reach out to any markets that may be in your area, because most likely the big box grocery stores will not have everything that you're looking for. If you are someone who hunts and is willing to retrieve some of their meals from the wild, it is best not to feed them any carnivorous or omnivorous game animals because you are opening yourself to the risk of potential contamination, poisons, toxins, or disease to your ferrets. So if this is something you are interested in doing, please look further into this because there is a lot more involved. If you are feeding a carnivorous animal, that animal could have eaten an insectivore like a skunk or a possum, for example, and that animal could have consumed an insect that ingested or was exposed to a toxin like a pesticide. Through bioaccumulation over time, the toxins can concentrate to concerning levels. You could also transfer poisons to your ferret if you are trapping mice or rats that may have ingested it, but this is more of a concern if you live in an urban area. Also, be sure to freeze wild game for a minimum of 4 weeks to eliminate any potential of passing on any parasites. Some people will say 2 to 3 weeks, but it's best to do 4 just to be safe. Some additional tips I have for you guys regarding their diet is to be careful not to give them egg yolk more than once or twice a week. Whole eggs are even better as it's packed with more nutritional benefits, but be sure to never give them egg whites by themselves because over time this can lead to a biotin deficiency, which can and will cause health problems down the road. Eggs can be given more often, about 2 to 3 times a week during shedding season, as this will assist with any fur blockage from grooming. When I'm referring to eggs, I am talking about chicken eggs, but quail eggs are another great choice as well. Another treat or supplement you can give your ferret is salmon oil. Salmon oil is rich in omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids, which are great for skin and coat health as well as heart and brain function. You can give this to them through a dropper, a syringe, or can be added to their food. Just be sure not to exceed over 1 teaspoon of salmon oil per ferret per week to avoid issues with their stool being too soft. If this is the case, you are giving them too much, so just be aware of this. Also, make sure you are getting salmon oil from a reputable brand that does not have any extra additives. You can also incorporate fish in their meal plan, just make sure the fish you are providing them is low in mercury. For ferrets, fish is not considered a main food protein as it would be for other mustelids like polecats and mink, but it is perfectly fine to feed a few times per month.
So that's all I have for today, guys. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them down in the comments below. And make sure you are staying up to date with newly emerging information, as the knowledge we have today is always evolving. So keep yourself in the loop by joining forums and communities surrounding these topics. That way we can provide our animals with what they deserve, and that is a happy and healthy life. If you guys found any value in this video whatsoever, please be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more pet care related content. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.